variety, and I hope you all enjoy. Thank you for coming.
Place that I visited where the people are genuine, are engaging, are, as it's a free translation, but open-hearted, Soutzoukakia in Greek. So it is something of a unique experience. So we have two regions that we're showcasing tonight. One is, like we said, from Amindo, higher elevation vineyards, and then the other one is from Naos.
There's a great regionality to Greece, similar to that of Italy. We're both Mediterranean.
It is true, like from one vineyard to another. And of course, winemaking has something to do with it. You see something totally different. And pretty much, it's the same grape.
Something like Nebbiolo, you that are playing for Rolo or Barbaresco, it's a grape that's very, very kind of savage in its youth. Has high acid, has high tannin. It doesn't give a lot of fruit in its youth. It needs a little while, 5, 7, 8, 10 years, before it starts to shed that kind of baby fat. The acid's calmed down a bit, the tannins melt in, a beautiful, elegant fruit comes out. It shares those same aromatic qualities, lots of red flowers. It's a thin-skinned grape, it's hard to grow, it needs a lot of care.
Ryan mentioned the word Nebbiolo, and those of you that have tasted the Italian wines made out of Nebbiolo, like Barbaresco, like Barone, might come up with the idea that it's very similar grapes, very, very similar characteristics as far as the land and the climate goes. The older the wine, the better it tastes. That's because by default, Xinomavro variety needs aging.
I talk about Greek wines in all places, not just in Greek restaurants or Greek culture. I think they have a place at the table of the finest cuisines and the finest restaurants, no matter what those are in the world.